Our immune system has the ability to discriminate between healthy cells and cancerous cells, which it does by recognizing a specific set of proteins or sugars known as antigens. Once an antigen-presenting cell recognizes a certain antigen as foreign, it notifies and activates the T cells, which then fight back against the disease by destroying the cancerous cells. The T cells also have the ability to remember the antigen for future recognition.
The functioning of T cells is regulated by a system of accelerators and brakes. T cells contain two major receptors on the surface, which function as brakes, CTLA-4 and PD-1. These receptors are called checkpoints. When these checkpoints are turned on, the T cells are inactivated and can no longer destroy abnormal cells.
To activate T cells, antigen-presenting cells need to simultaneously stimulate a special T cell receptor along with accelerator molecules like CD28, which it does by presenting the antigen along with co-stimulatory molecules such as CD80 and CD86. CTLA-4 works by competing with CD28 for CD80 and CD86, thus preventing the T cell from being activated. Cancer cells utilize this pathway to their own advantage by increasing the number of regulatory T cells in their environment. Thus, these regulatory T cells, which have a greater number of CTLA-4 receptors on the surface, prevent the activation of T cells. PD-1 receptor works by deactivating an already activated T cell when it binds to a molecule called PD-L1. PD-L1 also binds to CD80, thus preventing the activation of CD28. Cancer cells exploit this pathway by overexpressing PD-L1 on their surfaces, thus shutting down activated T cells. In other words, the T cells recognize but cannot kill the cancer cells.
Immunotherapy using checkpoint inhibitors aims to prevent the manipulation of these systems by cancer cells by blocking their ability to deactivate the T cells, thus utilizing the body's own defense mechanisms to fight cancer. Checkpoint inhibitors are antibodies that either attach to CTLA-4 receptors to prevent their inhibitory effect or form a barrier between the PD-L1 molecules on the cancer cell and the PD-1 receptors on the T cells. As the T cells are now no longer inhibited, they can proceed to destroy the cancer cells.
The FDA approved the first immune checkpoint inhibitor in 2011 for the treatment of advanced metastatic melanoma. Since then, immune checkpoint inhibitors have been used as the standard treatment in some forms of melanoma, lung cancer, and kidney cancer. Research is ongoing to develop new monoclonal antibody drugs for use as immune checkpoint inhibitors against many other types of cancers to improve patient outcomes and survival. Thank you. This is Amiteash.